Hello students, let's continue the class of theories of personalities and let's look on Sheldon's classification. So you know that Sheldon's classification, his theory is based on the variety of physic nature of a human beings. So it was based on body types, very much similar like the body structure which was given by the Kretschmer. And Sheldon's classification is based on three types. Those types are called to be endomorphic, mesomorphic and ectomorphic. You can see just pictures and Sheldon somatotype. Somato, you know, body type. Somato is a jargon which is used for body, the physical nature of a human being. So somatotype is a body type. So here the PPT tells you about the three pictures, right? And the picture which is left centered is endomorphs. Okay, they are little heavy built, and mesomorphs in between, the middle centered, which are slightly medium built, and the last one which is right centered, it's called to be ectomorphs. So it is the third build what we can see. And of course, who are these endomorphic people and endomorphic type of personality? So based on the body type, we can say that they are endomorphs. So you can just see the picture of endomorphs. Endomorphs are the people who are having big viscera. So viscera is considered to be the internal organs of a human being. So you can just see the size of the heart, right, holding your fist of the hand. So it depends upon if the people are big in nature, if they are hefty in nature. So usually the internal organs of the human beings also will be big. So people who are having big internal organs usually are the part of endomorphs. So these are the people who are with very weak bones and muscles. So you might have come across the people, if you touch a plumpy people in a very tight way, what do they say? It hurts them, right? So generally these are the people who are having big viscera's, but you know, the bones and muscles are very weak in them. But however, their personality character is, these are the people who are very much easygoing. They can put themselves into a ease, very comfort and support from others. So they want lot of comfort as well as support from the people or friends. So that kind of personality people are called to be endomorphic. The second type where we talk about the personality is mesomorphic. So mesomorphic are a little opposite of the first personality, that is endomorphic. So these are the people who are having very strong muscles and bones, but slim in nature. So the build is very much slim. However, but when compared to your the previous personality, we could see that these are the people who are having strong muscles as bones also. And the personality character of these people is they are highly active, very assertive in nature. So they are neither passive nor aggressive. So very assertive, very competitive, they hold responsibilities, and sometimes they do showcase the aggressive nature, but not always. And these are the people who struggle to achieve goals. Though they are responsible enough, they feel very tough to reach the goal. So the obstacles will be more for them, and it is said by the Sheldon what we can talk about. Well, ectomorphic personality, what we can speak about. So these are the people who are weak in nature, very skinny. Okay, so neither they are like the first personality what we spoke about, endomorphic, nor like a mesomorph personality. They are very weak in nature, very skinny kind of personality, and they are very afraid in nature. So they don't hold responsibilities nor they talk to people. So why they feel afraid is because they lack confidence and they feel nervous most of the times, and they never communicate to people. They suppress their emotions and they never express their emotion. So that kind of personality is called to be ectomorphic. So endomorphic, mesomorphic and ectomorphic are the three types of personality which belongs to this group. And this would be the last classification what we can talk about, and it is called to be the Carl Jung's classification. So the way Carl Jung's classification is, you know, you are having the base for all the types of personality. Like you were having Hippocrates classification, which was based on body temperaments. You had Kretschmer, which was based on body structure, right? And you had something related to Sheldon, which was on body type. The same way Carl Jung's classification is based on the mental structure, right? The mental structure of a human being. So you can just watch the PPT. He is a Carl Jung, and his mental structure, what he said is the mental structure of any human being is having the four major types. So thinking type, feeling type, sensation type and intuition type, which happens with the cognition of a human being. That is, cognition is nothing but the cognitive, the mind of a human being. And so this picture clearly tells about the four characteristics, that is, you sense, you feel, you intuit, and you think, right? So these are the four activities that is done through the mind. So the psychological functions, according to Carl Jung, is you sense it, you feel it, you intuit it, and you think about it. The four factors what we can see. And his classification is of 8 types, 4 major types, which is subdivided again into 4 types. So totally 8 types of classification what we can see. So the first type is, you know, that I spoke about the classification of Isaac, introvert and extrovert. The same two types is taken into the part of the 4 mental structure of a human being, that is thinking, feeling, sensation and intuition. So introversion, thinking type, extrovert, thinking type. And we are having introvert feeling type and extrovert feeling type. Then we are having introvert sensation type and extrovert sensation type. And we also are having introvert intuition type as well as introvert extrovert intuition type. So introvert and extrovert, which is divided into 4 psychological functions, that is thinking, feeling, sensation and intuition. Okay, let's see the characteristics. What could be the characteristics of a person who is with the mental structure of the part 1, thinking? And if he is an introvert thinking type, what would be his qualities? And if he is extrovert thinking type, what would be the factors? So introvert thinking type are the people who are more theoretical in nature, very much detached. They never talk to people. They are aloof. So aloof is, they are not friendly and they are afraid of external realities and very cold-blooded people. So such kind of personalities are called to be the introvert thinking type. And what could be the extrovert thinking type? So these are the people who are realistic in nature, who are practical oriented. So they want something with the facts. So they can support anything. They don't rely on theory, but they rely on facts. Okay, so if the theory is supported by the facts, they do accept it. So extrovert thinking type, who are rational in nature. Okay, so introvert thinking type and extrovert thinking type. Thinking type is aloof, not friendly, whereas extrovert thinking type is, they support theory with the facts. The second factor of the mental structure is feeling type. So introvert feeling type and extrovert feeling type. And introvert feeling type, the quality of an introvert. So these are the people who keeps on daydreaming, right? Daydreaming, and they are having strong feeling. So likes would be very strong and dislikes would be very strong. So strong feeling for likes and strong feeling for dislikes. And these people are the people who go on suffering but do not express their feeling towards others. So they suppress their emotion but they never express. And extrovert feeling type, these are the people who are very much helpful in nature. They feel for others, they admire others, and also these are the people who are very much social. So these are the people who express things but they never suppress. So introvert feeling type and extrovert feeling type. So feeling type in terms of introvert, they never express, whereas feeling type of extrovert, they do express their emotions. And the third part of the mental structure is sensation type. So introvert sensation type and extrovert sensation type. So people who are cool, very much aloof, not friendly. So these are the people who never communicate, they lack oratory skills. So they are good at writing than speaking. So they are interested in books, magazines, they read a lot. Okay, they are always reliant on theories. Whereas extrovert sensation people are the people who are very much good in eating. So good eaters we call them, and they are and eat anything eatable. So that the those are the qualities what we can see. And they are very much carefree, very friendly, very talkative in nature, you know, but they know they have no patience for abstract or theoretical ideas. So what I said is they just want the facts. So theory can be supported by them only through the facts. So those are called to be the extrovert sensation type. And intuition type, so this is the fourth mental structure of the or the psychological factor of Carl Jung. So it is divided into introvert intuition type and extrovert intuition type. Well, these are the people in terms of introvert intuition type, these are the people who are more subjective and more concerned with probabilities than actualities. So they don't want fact, they think, they worry about the probable acts. And these are the people who are very much moody, and most of the time they are unstable, very temperamental. So you cannot gauge them. Sometimes they keep themselves happy, sometimes they'll be very gloomy, sad, sometimes they are easily angered. And these are the people who behave like a theorist. So, you know, when you talk to them, you feel that they are a high theorist, a philosopher, rather than a person who is talking about the reality. And these are quite unstable in friendship, right? So you cannot trust them. They lack loyalty because they never express their emotions, and you cannot gauge what they actually do. Whereas extroversion intuition type, they are more outwardly very optimistic in nature, and they take and hold all the responsibilities. They are challenge seekers, risk takers, what we can talk about, and they try to achieve their goals because they express their feelings. So if they want to express anything, they express it. They express their happiness. These are the people who are very much trustworthy, very friendly. So these are the four basic personalities that is called to be the feeling, then you sense it, you are having intuition as a part of it. So the four factors what we talk about, the Carl Jung's personality, but it is taken into introvert and as well as extrovert intuition, or the feeling, sensation types what we can talk about. Thank you.